Hey guys, what's up? This is Serge, and today we're going to replicate the fine color effect seen at the start of this video. All this can be done right in Final Cut Pro without having to download or install any plugins. Down in our timeline, we have a normal clip. We'll start off by changing it to black and white. This is very simple to do. Just select your clip, and in the inspector, select the color inspector. In the saturation tab, click and drag the global puck all the way down. That's all you need to do to change it to black and white. Next, let's duplicate this clip and isolate just the color of the car. Hold down the Option key and drag up on the clip to make a copy of it. Place your playhead where you want to change your clip, and go back about 10 frames if you want to add the glitch effect like in my video. Press Option and left bracket key to ripple trim the start of your clip to the playhead. Head back up to the inspector, and go back to the video inspector. Select Color Board 1, and press Delete to remove the effect applied in the last step. Select the color inspector again, and from the drop-down menu, choose Hue Saturation Curves. To isolate the color of our car, we want the Hue versus Saturation Curve. Move your playhead to a frame where the color is nice and clear, and click the eyedropper beside the Hue Saturation Curves. In the viewer, click and drag out a sample of your selected color. In the color curves, you'll see three control points on your line. The middle control point, the one with a vertical line going through it, is your selected color, and the control points on each side of it are hue limit points. Click and drag the outside control points all the way down to desaturate all your other colors, and move them left or right to cover more or less of your selected hue. You can also move the middle control point up to make your color more vibrant. Now, to add the color glitch effect to the start of your clip, move your playhead to the start and zoom right in on your timeline. Press B on your keyboard to switch to the blade tool and blade your clip on every single frame. Do this about 10 times. Press A to switch back to the select tool, hold down the command key, and click on every second segment to select it. Press delete key to delete your selected segments. Here's what we have so far. For the next part, we'll go back to our original full color clip. Duplicate your top clip, place your playhead where you want to switch to full color, and press Option and left bracket key to ripple trim the start of your clip to the playhead. With the top clip selected in the video inspector, delete the hue saturation correction. Blade your clip on the first 10 frames, and delete every other segment. This brings us back to our original image. Next, we'll use a hue saturation curve to change the color of the car. Duplicate your clip, and once again, ripple trim the start of your clip to the playhead. In the inspector, select the color inspector, and from the drop-down menu, choose hue saturation curves again. This time, to change the color of the car, we'll use a hue versus hue curve. Click the eyedropper beside the hue versus hue curve, and in the viewer, select your color. Click and drag the middle control point up or down to change your color. If you still have some of your original color showing through, use the eyedropper again to select that color. Your vertical line in the hue versus hue curve will move to that specific hue value. Click on your curve line to add another control point and drag it up or down to fully change your original color. Add your glitch effect at the start of this clip. Let your timeline render out. And this is what your finished effect looks like. If you enjoyed this video, let me know by hitting the like button and checking out some of my other videos on my channel. If you like what you see, make sure to hit the subscribe button. I post new videos every week. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.